Andrew Cuomo played this game yesterday, and honestly, what he said is awful. So the governor of New York has been widely feted by the media for his brilliant leadership, despite the fact that his state got hit harder than any state in America, and he was late on the ball. Andrew Cuomo yesterday, he was asked about people who want to work, and here was his ridiculous, sneering answer.
How can the cure be worse than the illness if the illness is potential death?
But what if the economy failing...
Worse than death?
Is equals death.
Because of mental illness, the people
stuck at home.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't equal death. Economic hardship. Yes, very bad. Not death.
Right.
You want to go to work? Go take a job as an essential worker. Do it tomorrow. Right? You're working.
I am.
You're an essential worker. So go take a job as an essential worker.
People aren't hiring because of the
No, there are people hiring. You can get a job as an essential worker.
That's
so
insane.
Now you can go to work and you can be an essential
worker. What an absolute a-hole. I mean, seriously, what an absolute a-hole. What just unbelievable stuff from Andrew Cuomo there. So first of all, the baseline notion, that is the easiest and most scoundrel, it's the most scoundrel-like take on politics I can imagine, is death is not equal to any of the other things. Yes, that's true. Death is not equal to any of the other things. Death is worse than all of the other things for the individual. But for the society, we make these calculations all the time because that's called policymaking. And responsible policymakers make policy based on weighing a variety of factors, not one factor. If you're weighing one factor, you're a bad politician, you're a bad policymaker. Everybody understands this. Everyone understands this. No one's willing to say it out loud because they're gutless, but everybody understands that they're going to have to make these calculations. Andrew Cuomo pretending I'm saving every life. And okay, so I ruin the economy. Also, I just have a question for Andrew Cuomo. Why does he get to decide what an essential job looks like? You know what usually decides what an essential job looks like? People, human beings, the economy, not Andrew Cuomo. You know, saying that you are an essential worker, you know, I'll give you an example. Apparently, according to Andrew Cuomo, that reporter is an essential worker. And so I guess that all the people who are out of jobs, you know, working, who are working at restaurants, they can just get jobs as reporters. I mean, if they want to work, they can just get a job as a reporter. They can just go become a nurse or a doctor today. Like, what in the world? It's just another version of learn to code, right? It's just another version of you're going to lose your job and therefore you should just move into an essential industry, except we decide which industries are essential. You know whose jobs are essential? Everyone's jobs are essential. And to pretend that the job is not essential to the person or to the economy is to override both everybody else's free choice and the interests of the person who just lost their job. And there are 30 million of them. 30 million of them get a job as an essential worker. And honestly, like, what is Andrew Cuomo's history of being an essential worker other than working in government? And by the way, he was just elected to the position. It's not like, it is not as though he has provided some eminent and objective benefit to the state of New York through his service. That's not the way that this works. Essential workers. Even the phrase is ridiculous on its face. That's not to suggest that lockdowns weren't necessary and that there aren't truly essential workers, but I will point out that my job in the media is far less essential than a doctor or a nurse's job. There are gradations of essential. And by the way, I'm not sure that, why is it that my job is considered an essential job, right? Doing a podcast, and running a website. Why is my job considered an essential job in the same category as the people who are bringing you your groceries? Right? It's arbitrary and it's ridiculous and it's silly. The real reason that they say that the media are an essential job is because they don't want to run into a First Amendment violation is the real reason that they are doing that. But at the same time, they're saying that pastors and rabbis, I guess, are not essential jobs. So this is all arbitrary. And if it were connected to public health at this point, I'm all in favor of it. But I don't think that it's connected to public health. I think that he is using as an excuse for his bad public policy the if I save even one life routine. Now, he's not even the worst. I mean, first of all, that's an enormous amount of scorn for people who are losing their livelihoods. And you're seeing it in the media, too. The attempt to portray everybody who's protesting in favor of economy reopening and lockdowns being ended by the government, The attempt to portray those people as Nazi flag waving morons and white supremacists, Huffington Post compared them to the Charlottesville protesters. It's disgusting. Those are normal people who want to go back to work. And you know what? We live in a responsible country. We live in a republic and we will have restrictions on social distancing. We will have restrictions on wearing masks. Those will continue to be in place. But to pretend that those people's interests don't matter or that in aggregate, the only interest that matters is a policy that may or may not save lives, because we even don't know whether the lockdowns have saved lives in the first place. I think they probably saved some, at least in the short term. But we don't know, as the lockdowns are relieved, whether there's no counterfactual, right? We don't know what would have happened if we did Y when we did X. There's just no way to tell that. We don't have a multiple universes machine where we can tell what the counterfactual would have been. To pretend that you invariably have the right answer because you have decided that it's important that America be bubble boy and that there are no countervailing interests is just bad public policy making.
Thank you for tuning in to The Daily Wire, one of the fastest growing conservative media outlets in the country. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss out on any of our content.